In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about sending a request to the web server with different methods. And finally, I'm going to talk about the form, HTML form, and why we have to use a form and what are the form elements. I also write a simple server-side script using PHP language to give you an idea, a simple idea, as how the data is processed and how script can collect the information that is passed from the HTML page. In general, there are two methods of sending the information to the server. One is called get method, and the other one is post method. Any link you click on any page that you go to on the internet uses the get method to request send a request to the server. A get method always starts in this format. So if I want to go ahead and create a link, let's call it test.html. Whenever you want to send a request to the server, simply, this is what you have to do. As soon as the person clicks on the test label, then this request will be sent to the server. Along with this request, I can send some information to the server or to the test.html in this case, so the test.html can process those information. Of course, HTML is in a static content, and if I want to do this and send this information and render different result based on this information that I'm sending to the server, the file that I'm calling and my href must be a server-side script. There are many different server-side scripts. One that is PHP I'm going to use here, Servlet, JSP, ASP.NET, which is C-sharp or VB, so many other languages like Python and so on. Now, in this case, when I click on this link, it will actually send a request to the server, calls the test.php. Along with this request, I can start sending some information as well. For instance, if I want to change the background color of the page, I can simply go ahead and add a question mark, which separates the parameters from the URL or the file name. And each parameter consists of two parts. We usually call them key equal value, or we can say name equal value, right? So the name of the parameter as what is the name and what is the value you want to pass to the test.php. So if I want to change the color of the background, I can simply say color and I can go ahead and say red, right? So in this case, when the request is sent to the server to test.php, test.php has access to these parameter, in this case color, and it can simply change the background color. Let me go ahead and change this file name to color so it makes more sense. And I'm going to create that file for you. So here I will just go ahead and create a PHP file. I'll call it color.php. So in color.php, it can be a regular HTML. Remember, with PHP or any other server-side scripting language, you still have to produce HTML, right? Because the only thing browser understand is markup language. So if I want to change the background color of this page, simply I have to go and open the style tag, right? Somewhere in the head. So I go ahead, I'll create the selector. In this case, it's going to be body tag. And I just go ahead and say background color, and I'll put blue, right? So if I save this and run this on the browser, see if I can bring this one in so you guys can see it better. Okay, here you go. So when I call this page, this become background blue. Now, what is that I want to do is simply I want to be able to call this PHP file and pass different parameter. Remember, the very first thing is whenever I want to call the PHP or any script, server-side scripting language, I have to separate the script name from the parameter list. So in this case, I want to say color, and I will simply want to pass the color code red or name red. So in this case, when it goes to the PHP file, it has to grab this information and change the background color accordingly. The part that changes the background color in this case is a static. So in order to be able to make this dynamic, I simply have to start the PHP right in here. This is how you actually put a delimiter to separate the HTML from the markup or style language. It's very similar to the concept of whenever I want to add a style, I have to open and close in order to tell the browser I'm not doing HTML, this part is style. So I'm saying, okay, I start PHP right here and I end PHP right after this, right? So in order to collect this information, since the method is get, I just have to use super global variable, they call it, which carries all the information regarding the parameter comes in. So if you remember, when I called this page, the parameter name was color, right? So in order to get red in this case, I simply have to go and put color here. So this is saying get parameter is color that I'm looking for, right? So of course I have to print this. So I just go ahead and print this value. Now if I go back and refresh this page right now, let me see if I can get the browser. Okay. So if I go ahead and hit enter now, simply you can see the background color changes. So I can change this one to any color I want, right? Now, the good thing about this is if I go and view source right now, you do not see any PHP. The only thing browser can handle is markup language. So PHP introduces or produces the HTML content. If you would like to send more parameter, you can using the get method. Okay, simply go ahead and add ampersand to separate the parameters from each other. So again, same rule, name equal value. So I go here and I say name is equal, let's say John, right? So if I hit enter, then simply this will pass two parameters to the PHP file. Let me just go ahead and put this one in here, right? Now, of course, if I want to see the result here, I can go to my PHP file and I could simply say hello, right? And now I want to get the value of that parameters coming to this script. So I can simply go ahead and say get, and the parameter name, if you remember, was name. So I can put the name in there, right? What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this one in H1 tag so you can see it better. Let me just go ahead and do that. And as soon as I refresh the page with the same parameters, and simply it prints the value for you, which in this case it doesn't, because I do not have the echo here to print the value, right? So if I go back here, refresh this, simply can print this. Now I have the option to change this to anything I want, Mike, right? So now I have created a dynamic page. One thing about the get method is you can always see the parameters that are passing to the script on the URL, and get is limited to the number of character you send to the server. So you cannot do a file upload. You cannot send a huge information. It simply gets truncated. There is a security problem with this. If you want to actually do a login form, you want to create a login form and you want people to enter their username and password to log into the page, you never use get, because the password can be seen when the form has been submitted, right? So let's go back to our page, and we want to start doing some of these things in different ways. So as you can see here, I have created a link called red, right? It changes the red. I can pass the name as well here to red lover, right? I want to create another one in this case. Let's go ahead and do that as well. So this one I will do with yellow, and of course is yellow lover, and your color is yellow, right? Let's go ahead and run this now. So if I look at this right now, I have two links. They both will call color.php and pass this parameter. So if I mouse over the links on the status bar right here, you should be able to see the parameters. I'm sending this one, so simply it would change to red and pass the name red lover, and I can go with the yellow and it does the exact same thing, right? So this is the get method, and as I said, you always see the parameters on the URL. There is another way of doing this as well. I can use a form tag to send the information through either get or post method, which I will cover in the next video. Thank you for watching.